So today we're going to discuss the chapter, The Enemy. Come on, quickly, just let's revise it. Yes, what is this chapter about? Yeah, what is the problem that Dr. Sadao faces? And how does he solve it? Varun, tell me. 19 marks you got in English, that means you really need to focus. Kitne aaye hain? 18 aaye hain? Huh? Accounts mein aaye 19? Toh bahut khush hain hum log usse. Yes, Varun, please stand up. Tell me about the chapter Enemy. What was the problem that Dr. Sadao had and how did he resolve it? What was the problem? Yes, what problem did the American soldier pose? He was half dead. That was the problem. Okay. How did Dr. Sadao solve that problem of him being half dead? Yes, Arsimar? What do you call a person who goes against the country? Who's not loyal to the country? Yes. Traitor. Very good. Yeah, so we have, yes, what about online students? Then we have the word traitor. Act of being a traitor. We also say treason, isn't it? Right? So here, Dr. Sadao is afraid. He's very dutiful. He's very, concerned about his duty. He had not been sent away for the war because he was working on a very important scientific research, right? That is making the wounds recover quickly without getting infected longer, right? And so his duty could, or his loyalty towards the country, it could not be questioned. But because if there was an American soldier in the house, there could be a problem, okay? Right? So Hannah, his wife, supported him. Yes. And what about this soldier or this prisoner or the American as he recovered? What was his reaction towards Sadao and Hana? Yes, how did the soldier behave with them? Yes, Maya? He was a nice person? Oh, very nice. He was very friendly?
Yes.
Because he was? He was brave. But he felt very safe. And he was quite surprised that they are Japanese and how they think differently, right? That why can't all Japanese be like you, okay? Right, but yes, do you think Dr. Sadao is going to keep him in his house for a long time? Why not? Because of the problem that we have discussed. So what was the solution that Sadao found? Yes, Lagan, tell me, what was the solution? Please tell me, what was the final solution? What was the solution? Was it doing his surgery? Please, class, listen. Was it doing his surgery or was it something else? What is the final solution? Tell me, ma'am. Yes, Arsimar. That was the final solution. Did General Takema send his assassins?
No.
Then what did Sadao do? He wrote a letter. Okay. Did he get a reply to that letter?
No.
Because did he post that letter?
No.
Where did he keep that letter? He just kept it in his drawer. He did not complete the letter. Even he started writing a letter to the chief of the police, reporting this matter, but he did not send the letter. What was the final solution, Bhavni? Yes, the final solution was to send him away. Where did he send him away? To an island. How far was that island? Very far. How far? Very, very far. It was too far away, right? But yes, Malik, what instructions were given to the American when Sadao sent him away in his boat? Right? He gave him the boat, he gave him a blanket, he gave him water and a torch, and he gave him very, very strict instructions. What were they? Yes. That's it. He's, and after sunset, he's not supposed to, you know, signal him and not send any signal there. He's not supposed to light the fire. And if he runs out of the food and all, what was he supposed to do? Where is he going to get it from? That then he has to eat the food raw only. He's not supposed to cook it. Lighting a fire, that smoke would come. And because the island was not very far. And which ship should he wait for? He should wait for the Korean ship. So if he gets on the Japanese ship, he'll be back to square one.
Yes.
What is that? Again, in the hands of the an enemy. Okay, right? Yes, what is the message here? Is there any theme? Is there any message of this story? What is it? Yes, that doctors are very helpful people. Or servants should be educated. Or yes, what it's about loyalty, how we should show our loyalty. What is there? Which is the greatest religion, which is the great service of all?
Humanity.
And Dr. Sadao taught us this lesson through his he was a doctor, right? So he did both his duties as a doctor and as a loyal citizen. How did he do his duty as a doctor? Yes?
He treated him
and he saved, and he took a risk there, right? Because the soldier was half dead. First of all, they were in the mind that let us leave him there and let him die. Both of them had this idea, but none of them was cruel enough to leave that person to die. They brought him inside, and so Dr. Sadao did the surgery. What was the surgery? What was the surgery? Yes, very good. Simar has read this chapter. Ankit is not giving any reply. Jatin is waiting, right? Ma'am, don't ask me any question. Okay? Yes, Varun is thinking what to do. And Pulkit never replies. Yes? Yeah, there's a lot for you to read. Lot of reading to be done. Okay? Yes, so what was the surgery? The surgery was the removal of the bullet, okay? And yes, what you can say were Hannah's thoughts while the surgery was going on? How did Hannah behave during the surgery? What were Hannah's thoughts when she saw this man? What did she think about? Yes? She said, yuck? Oh, she said, yuck? That I should do this, is it? She vomited, yes, because she had never assisted in a surgery before. And the sight of blood made her very nauseous. Okay, that's quite natural to happen. Then as Sadao was there busy doing the surgery, he was removing the bullet. She took a look at the young man. She noticed something very strange. What was it that she noticed? Yes, red marks were there on the man's neck. And yes, so Harsimran has read the chapter very nicely. Very good. And yes, so she noticed those marks on his neck. And she had heard a lot about the stories of torture. So criminals torture, how they are tortured. The prisoners of war, yes, they are not allowed to escape, and how you have these prisoner camps and where they are tortured and of course ill-treated, right? So when she saw those marks, and she is very shocked that yes, these stories of torture are quite true, right? And why do you think the torture of the prisoners it takes place? Because they're enemies, that's why they have to be tortured. Yes, yes. To get some more information about the enemy, about their location, about the strength, about the forces. Yes. Do you think the torture, it should be a part of investigation?
Yes. Yes. Okay. So if the enemy is not tortured, they will not speak the truth. Then once again, when we talk about, human rights, and we talk about people, all this, get the cruelty and all. What about all that? Nobody listens to all that. So you agree torture is a part.
Yes.
The law has the right to torture.
Yes. Yes.
Especially the forces, the soldiers, they can.
Yes.
Okay. Otherwise, you will not get information. What if a person dies during torture? Very bad, very sad it is. Yes. No, but tell me, do you think the police, okay, we're talking about, this is a very different situation. We're talking about the enemy here torturing the soldiers, right? Fine. And Hannah wondering that, okay, is this really true? In times of peace here, right? When we talk about people taken away as criminals, they're put in prison. What about their torture? Is that torture justified? Yes.
Yes.
They have committed crimes, so they should be tortured till they confess. Is it? Yes, Krish, what do you have to say? No, it doesn't happen. Okay, then why is Hannah so shocked when she sees those red marks? Why is Hannah so shocked to see those red marks? So she was there, of course, in the belief that this has happened, because she had heard of stories of torture. And General Takima, he was known for his, the way he would torture the enemy. And of course, at home also, he was known for the domestic violence, right? And how he would be there violent with his wife, which is not at all acceptable. You don't show your authority that way. You keep your authority in your workplace, okay? Not at home, right? So Hannah was there. Yes, she assisted Saddam in the surgery. And she gave the chloroform to the prisoner. Yes. And so anesthesia right here, chloroform. Okay, so anesthesia so that the person would remain unconscious. But the man was still there groaning in pain as Sadao reached the bullet. And how did Sadao come to the conclusion that this wound was not a fresh one, but it was comparatively old? How did he come to this conclusion? Let's see how well you have read the chapter, right? What happened when the man was washed ashore? What, opened his wounds again on the shore? The rocks, the sharp rocks, right? So it seemed as, so he had been shot from behind. And he was running away from the custody of the enemy. And so he fell over there in the water, reached the shore. And on the shore, what happened? The sharp rocks, they pierced his skin and the wound had started bleeding again. There we noted how Dr. Sadao did a very emergency, a kind of an action. He picked up moss and put it there to stop the bleeding. But yes, he could make out that the wound, it was a little quite old because the young man had lost a lot of blood, right? And he was quite weak. And Hannah helped him and she gave the anesthesia and he was able to remove the bullet. Okay, right. Then now comes one very important part about the servants. What role did the servants play in this whole story? What were the things that the servants realized and Sadao did not? What were the things that the servants were aware of? And it seems that Sadao, because of his education, he was not aware of that. What was it? helping the enemy, or yes, an enemy is an enemy, no matter in what condition that person is, right? So this, the soul, you know, the servants, they were able to understand this better, yes? And they were surprised at why Siddha was not able to understand this. What did they, you know, blame this lack of understanding on? Why was he unable to understand this? What did he think had happened to Siddha that he's not able to understand this? Very good, Harsimar. Very good, right? Yeah, because he went to all the drame bars are in 12B. Yes. All the people who are there, you know, just overacting here. They are in this. Fine. I have appreciated him. I think so. That is more than enough. Okay. I'll see. Were we given blue cards this time? I will. Yours what? Okay. I'll give you tomorrow. Remind me tomorrow. I'll give you blue cards then. Two you want? Well, I'm distributing sweets. You don't want one? You want two? Right? Am I right? Okay. Okay. Yeah, I find a reason every day to give you a blue card. That's nice. Okay, so Siddha was different because he went to America for his education. Now, in the final scene, when Siddha was standing once again, as the story started, and he was just looking out towards the sea and towards the islands that are there beyond his house. And he waited for a couple of days, and yes, he was not getting any kind of signal there from the island which the soldier was supposed to give. He was reflecting upon the days that he had spent in America. What was his impression? What were the memories that he had about his stay in America? Yes, Bhami? Yes? He's not speaking right now. Yes, but we need to speak. Yes, Siddha. And no, what were the memories? Yeah, this was the most pleasant memory that he had, that he met Hana over there. Okay, what else? What else? Why did he let that soldier go? What about his stay over there in America? Was he happy about the stay over there? What kind of experience did he have? What did he think about the people? Yes, Bhavneet? Yes, Manreet? The sound of? What memories did he have? Yes, Udit, tell me. Abhishek, tell me. Abhishek got 37 marks out of 40. Yes, what are the memories? Yes, Abhishek, tell me. Online students, you want to give me the answer? Tanisha, Mia, Akriti, Aditya. So what were the memories that he had? He did not have a pleasant time. Yes, Mohit, please listen now. He did not have a pleasant stay over there. Right? And of course, he did feel the prejudice that people had towards Japanese. And he was not very comfortable with the landlady, although she did help him when he was not well. That was the only time, you know, like that when she nursed him and she took care of him. But otherwise, he felt that he never had any fond memory of that place. Because, yes, just like people here, they were prejudiced against the Americans over there. Also, they all had their prejudices against the Japanese, right? So he was not at all happy with his experience. He had gone for higher studies. His father wanted him to become a surgeon. He went there and now he's thinking about that. Then he wonders that, why did I let this person leave? I could have let that person die. And that is where we get the message of the story. It is because he realizes that above all, a most selfless thing that we can do is being a good human being. Now, when we discuss this chapter here, we come across the word prejudice, right? What is prejudice? What is prejudice? Yeah, we have a preconceived opinion. Ek pehle se humne banayi hui opinion that Americans are like this, or Chinese are like this, or Bengalis are like that, or South Indians are like this. We have our opinion, isn't it? What is a stereotype? What's a stereotype? I have a stereotype image, right? Society has made stereotypes. Like, of course, when you talk about here about girls and boys, there is stereotypical behavior that we expect. What is that? When you talk about stereotypes, and how are they different? Prejudices are opinion. Before I've met that person, I have an opinion about that person. And why is that? Because things I've heard about, things I have read, right? So I have this opinion that I'm prejudiced here. Like people might think about Punjabis. You know, what do you think people think about Punjabis? Yeah? What? That they're always jovial and laughing and they love their aloo paranthas and makki ki roti. Is it? Yes. Okay, enough. What are stereotypes? Like our society has stereotype behavior, right? That girls are expected to behave in this way. Boys are supposed to be very strong and confident and bold. And you think that girls are there very, feminine and delicate. And accordingly, our roles are also distributed. Okay? You might get a question from this chapter. That here, the behavior of the servants towards Sadao, was it because of a prejudice? Was it because of a stereotype? Stereotype. Prejudice. Prejudice kya hota hai? What's a prejudice? What is prejudice opinion? An idea, opinion you have about a person, a community, a country, which is not naturally your opinion, but it is based on what you have heard or read. Okay? Right? What's a stereotype? We expect people to behave in this way. That is our stereotype. Right, so when we immediately think about a person here, we immediately put them in slots. That this is the kind of a behavior that is expected. Okay, right? How can we rise above prejudices? This is also one very important line here in this chapter. By being aware, by reading more, by our interaction, right? And once again, let us form our own opinions. Let's not, follow opinions that have been made by others. Do you remember the chapter in class 10th, you had 100 dresses?
Yes.
Yes. So there about Wanda Petronsky. Do you remember? Yes. So how those two girls, they used to tease her, Peggy and Maddie, right? Because her name was different and because she was a Polish immigrant. So these things here, when we are not aware about other person's behavior, about their community, about their culture, then our behavior becomes different. So we need to break this thinking. We need to be more aware. We need to be more, open towards acceptance and towards change. So, and in the classroom also, when you have bullying also, right? We've read all that in the 100 dresses and it must have been discussed also. So that is one example here, okay? Right?